Yeah, now that we learned about TorchMetrics and we saw that it can make the computation of metrics such as the accuracy more convenient, let's actually add some TorchMetrics code to our Lightning model here. Yeah, so for this video, let me show you a little trick in Visual Studio Code. So I already prepared the code for this video. However, I want to show you that this code is almost identical to the code that we used in 5.2 part 3 when we implemented our Lightning module. So we are going to add these TorchMetrics code lines to it, which I already prepared for you. And what you can do here in Visual Studio Code is you can click onto files and then you say compare selected. So you get a view here which has both codes side by side. So you can really see easily what I have changed here. So as we can see, the imports are almost the same. I'm now importing TorchMetrics. So on the right hand side is the new file. On the left hand side is the old file. Then our Lightning module here, it's also very similar. What has changed is now that to the init function, I'm initializing these TorchMetrics accuracy objects. And since MNIST is a multi-class classification task, we set the task to multi-class and we specify the 10 classes. So another change is that we have this code here that is new in the training step method. So here we have the predicted labels that we obtain using TorchMax on logits. So that is something we already discussed in the context of the SoftMax model, where we are getting the labels using ArcMax on logits. And then here we are computing the training accuracy. So this is using TorchMetrics because we defined the training accuracy up here. And here we are now calling it on our predicted labels and the true labels. So this will update the TorchMetrics accuracy object here. And then we are logging the accuracy here with a progress bar, and we compute it on each epoch here. So we are computing this every epoch, not every mini-batch. So we say on step false. So it's not computed every time we do a training step. This logging only takes place after each epoch. Then similarly here in the validation step method, we define the code to get the validation set labels, the validation set accuracy, and then logging the validation set accuracy. If we have done that, you can see everything else is the same, except of course we can make our code simpler since we compute the accuracy above. We don't need our own compute accuracy functions anymore. We are just simply using TorchMetrics now. And besides that, everything is the same. So let me show you the single file view so it's a little bit easier. So here we have the whole code file without the annotation. And yeah, here I added some comments to make sure it's clear what has changed compared to 5.2. So yeah, it's very simple code. We just modified a few parts here where we added the TorchMetrics code. If that looks good, we can hit play and train the model. So yeah, we can see the training accuracy is now displayed during training, along with the validation set accuracy and the validation loss. And yeah, here we see the final model after training. There's only one more thing missing, and that's the test accuracy, which will be the topic of a future video. So in this video, we learned how we can use TorchMetrics to make the computation of the accuracy more convenient during training. In the next video, we will also learn how we can use TorchMetrics for the test set evaluation.